Hey everybody, back to get the trail cams. Cool X. Okay, now I'm approaching the, I wasn't gonna film much till I got up there, but I'm getting near the totem pole and I don't see it. Oh, it is up. Okay, good. I was like, I think they took it completely, but it's still there and it's up. Okay. Phew. If it was completely gone, that would have been weird. Alright, here we are. You guys, I've lost track. This is like almost the 20th, I think, time I've been here. So I'm getting pretty familiar with the place. There's all kinds. I didn't film it, but I walked up from down there. It's about, I don't know, half a mile to here. And from the car. And there's all kinds of new stuff. So I'm pretty confident that they're here, as cold as it is at night. They're still here. It doesn't... Ooh, did they add that one stick? Okay, I'll have to go back and look at the pictures, you guys. By the way, Facebook, you guys. A lot of people don't realize that. Sorry, I'm out of breath. A lot of people don't realize that I'm on Facebook. I have lots of stills, tons of structure pictures. Pictures other people have taken out of my videos, stuff like that. So just go to Facebook, guys. It's right there. I don't get hits. Doesn't matter. If you like it, I don't care. Like, it's just so you guys can see stuff and people can post pictures. So, I gotta ask Dan, he's away. I feel like they might have added this stick. I put that one down there. It's actually supporting the entire totem pole. It would just fall over this way. And we did that on top. I swear, I think that stick is new. I could be wrong. We'll find out. Dan has pictures. Here's Dan's rocks he leaves. Oh, they're all different. There's another one, Dan. You're going to have to tell me. You know, put in the comments, Dan, because that way people that watch this can get the answer. But I'm pretty sure he left these rocks in threes, and now they're in twos. I know it sounds crazy, but I'm pretty sure we'll have to ask him that. All right, I'm going in. I'm not going to do crazy long clips today. I'll just keep turning on and off. I haven't heard a sound yet, nothing. Not a noise, but I've also been, this is the most noise I've made was talking. I was very quiet coming up here. I love this area. This was all made right before I found this place. All right. Actually, you know what? I'm gonna film my way back. This is where everybody finds them. I've walked, you guys, I've walked forever this way. I get the big ones, the big black ones down here, but this group cloaking, whatever hiding thing goes on right in here. Every single time. So, you can see I'm just following their path that goes to the totem pole. Let me see if I can type this, it doesn't shake. Look for dark spots. Trees, real thick tree cover, this is where we're always seeing them. I'll zoom right in on them. And yes, you guys, they're blob squatches. That's the pictures we get. The latest ones, because, but they're there and it helps me a lot. So I know some other people that may not believe in Bigfoot aren't gonna be happy with those. But to me, these days, after doing all this and doing this on my, you know, the pictures and the videos and stuff, I've realized that those pictures are probably the real ones. Anything too good is not Bigfoot or Sasquatch. They just don't make those kind of mistakes. They don't get hit by cars. They don't run out in the middle of fields, things like that. These videos of the white one going across a field, it looks real to me, but it just can't be. I know these guys. There's no way that one of these things is just going to go walking across a field. It won't happen. All right, trail cams. Shit. I don't know where they are. I think I remember. The only way I marked them is with is by a structure I'm looking for. It's like one of those round type of deals in it, somewhere in here. There is ones within miles. On the way up here, I passed some a few miles back. Just praying that no one's parked and coming up here, because if I saw a hunter up here, I'm not sure what I would do, what I would tell him to leave. Because I don't want him. I don't think he's going to shoot one. I just don't want them, you know, hunting in here, making these guys leave. I'm sure they can handle themselves, but it'll make them even more weary of me, basically. Think that I'm with them or something. Not a sound. Okay, there's my bent thing right there. My bent tree. I think the trail cams are right in here somewhere. You guys, I know you would think you remember, but after watching videos and watching clips and stuff like that, it tends to blend together. You'll swear you'll remember. Did I find him? I got him. Yes. Usually, I think that worked out pretty good reviewing him on camera last time, but I think this time I'm not because of them, just because of them. I don't want him to. I'm probably on camera right now because there's the trail cam. Where is it? There it is. Been there for 1 week. Seems like a month. So I only get to go up there once a week. Alright, let's take a look. You know what? Let's just take a look. It's fun to look, right? Let's see. Batteries could be dead. Nope. I wish that if they were dead, it's a good sign. It means they took a lot of pictures. You know what? Let me get this off. God, I'm sure they're staring at me right now. Hold on. Let's get a nice shady spot. Yeah, I know this video is a little unusual, guys, but I don't care. I'm just kind of bringing you for my whole ride today. Let's see what we got. Okay, that's me. That's me. What in the world is that? Oh, it's a deer. Is it a deer, guys? Just a deer. I'm not going to play the video again. Wow. I've never seen, hardly ever see a deer up here. Oh, we got another video. Nothing in it. It's amazing how this thing takes pictures. Sorry. Takes pictures, and it's supposed to take a picture and a video, and it's sometimes only taking a picture. I don't get it. But then the next one, it'll have a picture and video. Oh, we got another weird one. Hold on. Another video, too. Sorry. This is the first, guys. I'm just trying to... I'm thinking this is cool, right? I'm not, just to show you guys, I'm not hiding anything. By the way, most people are very paranoid researchers. If they get a picture or something, that they'll hide it and it'll become some big secret. And, you know, that is so silly. Like, I just want you guys to know right now, when it happens to me, I don't care if he walks up right here and high fives me, okay? That video, as fast as I possibly can, will become yours. I want to give that to everybody. I'm not out to be like, this is mine. I'm making millions of dollars. And what in the heck was that? That was really loud. Sorry. So I just want you guys to know that whatever's, you know, we're in this together. I'm not. If I can make $1 million, great. Who wouldn't want $1 million? But I'm not going to do it keeping something secret. I'll put it out there and who knows. But it's just want you guys to know that I don't keep secrets. Anything that I get is yours, I promise, okay? All right, so there's another deer. It's actually a video, I'm not sure what he's doing. He's a big guy. A couple deer. I wonder if they're not here, they better be here. All right, I got all kinds of weird looking like white type blurred images. On my last one, you guys, you gotta see the blurred image I had that was flashing through the screen. The top of the picture was perfect. The bottom was perfect. The middle was this insane blur. You can see it on Facebook. Oh, we got night. We got night. Yes, we got night in a video. We got night. Love it. I don't see anything though. I'll have to look at that closer. Another night one, guys. Oh yeah, come on. I just want him to come out and wave at you guys. Two nights, that was good. There could be something there. We'll see. A lot of times you can't tell until you get on the bigger screen. A video here. Oh, it's a bird. Did you see that? That was crazy. That wasn't crazy, but it just surprised me. Yeah, you can see him right there. Watch. A bird, I'm pretty sure. Another picture without a video. I do like that it gives the temperature of the video. It's a deer, which is cool because I never see deer up here. It's bow season. Maybe they know they're safer in the Bigfoot world than they are in the people world. Oh, I see something moving back there. Look at that, you guys. I can only show you my thumb, but look, watch right there where my thumb is, okay? Right there. Right in the middle, from one frame to another. Watch this. There's something there, and then there's not in the bushes. That's going to be interesting to see. I got a ton of stuff on here, you guys. A lot of video that I'm not seeing anything in. Which tells me something could set it off in the background. Let me just go through it real quick. I got something really weird looking on it right here. Everything's clear, but right there is all white and fuzzy. I just can't tell what the heck that is. Can you guys see what that is? Looks like a ghost bear. I got a bunch of pictures of him. Look, now it's like some kind of blur. It's like some kind of smoke or something. What is going on? Is it light? Maybe it's light. There's another one. All right, so this is cool. We got a bunch of stuff, you guys. Deers, it looks like, mostly. I got 65 pictures. There's the other one I wanted to show you guys, the people that haven't seen it. It's pretty amazing. It's going to be hard to see on here, but this red thing, I have no idea what it is. It's bright red. It almost looks like the color of like the inside of your body red. And the bottom of the picture is perfectly clear. The top is perfectly clear. There's just this amazing blur. Look at what it's doing to the tree on the right-hand side. I mean, something incredibly magical was going through past that screen at high speed. See, everyone says that these things can mess with trail cams. I don't believe that they do it on purpose. I believe that they have an energy that's just with them. And when they do go near them, it's automatic. It's not like, hey, I'm zapping this camera. It's not like that. It just happens to the cameras. I don't see that with my real camera that I'm using right here, but I've never had one go right past the front of it either. So, I mean, at least not close. So anyway, guys, let me click off. I'm going to get that trail cam, which has probably been filming this entire time. And I'll put them away, and then I'll film again, okay? Bye. All right, trail cam's recovered. I have to go back to the boulder where Dan left stuff. He has a picture of the way he left everything. Every time we come back, it's completely gone. And anything they don't want, they leave, but they change it. They move it. I left my pocket knife there. I think that was on my last video. They're in here. This is where they always are. It's a great place to be in a group. So we've been discussing the cloaking thing, guys. You know, it's real hard for me to believe. I'm not a big fan in this. And I gotta tell you, I've... Based on what... It just is just a guess. But based on all these group photos I get, I know some of you haven't seen them yet. But I have some amazing grouped up photos of different creatures together with the Bigfoot out front. And they're always together. The first time I saw them, the biggest one that's here, the biggest one I've seen here, is this gigantic head. And I saw him moving behind them, and he moved into place, and then he put his head down. And I believe, I know it sounds crazy, that the others were kind of in this cloaked little ball. You know, you guys, it's not magic. They could be, you know, it could be a device. It could be, that's why I feel like it's one that's doing the cloaking. Now, I could be completely wrong, but... Or maybe they'll use one because it takes energy, and that way the other one can kick in later if they need to do it longer. I don't know, but this is confusing. This stuff. So, don't yell at me. Don't type. I'm not saying they cloak. I'm not saying they don't. I'm saying I'll buy whatever. If I find out for a fact right now, I wouldn't be surprised either way. Let's put it that way. A little bit. They just don't want you to come through here. And normally I walk down in here and get lost. So I need to go this way. Let's get to that rock. Now, you guys, I try never to film the same spot, so I'm always taking a new route or looking at new stuff. Oh, check that out. That's cool. Okay, see what happened there? That's a bear. Oop. Just got my bee laying on me. Used to be a bee's nest in the ground. You can see there's the nest. And he really, like, did a number on that thing. So there's definitely a bear frequently walking through here. He likes it here. He's safe here. Saying is I always take you somewhere new. I have so many spots that I found that I'm ready to film, you guys, but everyone's like, don't leave yet. So I haven't left yet. They just feel, you know, I feel the same way in a sense of where they're getting used to me. I also feel like if you go into a new, brand new area that's really never been frequented by people ever, and you get a good spot, that it's easier to see them that first time. They're not as cautious the first time you come in. There's the rock. Every single thing's gone. Cool. Look at that. Now, I have no memory of how he laid it out, but there's nothing on it. That's cool. Go check it out. Dan will be happy. They like Dan. We've established they like Dan because he leaves them all kinds of treats. I can tell. They know I'm here, and they're watching me. I can feel it in my bones, you guys. I can feel it, okay? Like, because this is... Last time, I showed up to check the same thing. I got these crazy whistles from right over here, the closest ones I've ever had. And I already had that feeling. It's because of this rock. They know if I come in here, I might leave stuff, and they get excited. Have not heard anything, but I can feel it. Oh, yeah. You guys see it? This is they bring these sticks in here. Some fall down, but the rest they bring in. Wow. What do we leave? It's all gone. I think he had an apple. way up in that tree, and that's gone. I remember that. He was sticking an apple somewhere. Everything, there's not one thing left. I can't wait to see. Okay, so you guys, again, I'm just making this plan up right now. Some of the people I don't stay in touch with a lot, or you're just watching this for the first time, just go to Colorado Facebook. That doesn't make sense. Colorado Bigfoot on Facebook. And we'll have the pictures there. If you don't see it right on the thing, you can go to where the photos are, click on that, and it shows you all our pictures. It's only a month old. You guys already have 4,500 likes on there. We're getting some pictures in there. It's pretty good. But for stuff like Dan's picture, he's in Honduras right now. Hopefully he can mail it to me, and I'll, internet it to me somehow, and I will put it up on Facebook so we can see how the way he left that. But whatever it is, they got everything. Oh, here, let me click off. I got some stuff for them I'm going to leave, okay? I don't even care, okay? I'm so happy hearing that one whistle because it confirms that they're still here. I knew they would be, but I get worried that they're leaving and I won't see them for 6 months. So thank God they're here. Oh, what in the heck was that? I felt that in the ground. I'm not kidding, I just felt the ground move below me. Why? Something behind, it felt like it was behind me. That is freaky. That's the second time that's happened to me here. The first time I was all the way up. I've only been up there once, all the way at the top of the hill. It's about 2 miles from here. And it's pretty open up there, and there wasn't that much, like, structures going on. Dan found, like, this really cool writing on the ground. And I'm looking, I was filming the woods, and all of a sudden I got the, like, I don't know if he stomped the ground or what, but I just heard something in the woods and felt it on my feet. That's all I'm gonna say. I'm not gonna say he bluff charged me. I don't even like the bluff charge. Whoever made that up, it's stupid. Bluff charge. I know they do stuff like that. I just think the term is just silly. It's not really a bluff. It's more of like a warning charge. Bluff sounds like he was scared. I can promise you they weren't scared. Go figure, you can't see a damn thing. This always happens, guys. I come up, I'm like, let me just get my trail cams. And then I end up in some new spot somewhere. Now when I say new, I mean new within this gigantic world. I'm talking about a mile this way, maybe 2 miles that way, a mile that way. So yes, I smoke an electronic cigarette. If you guys see me with this, this is my Mark 10. I don't smoke cigarettes, but when I'm in the woods, it calms my nerves. Okay, so I'm not where I thought I was. Guys, if you're ever wondering what I'm doing with the camera, like, what is he doing? It's because once in a while I need to look through the viewfinder because you can't always see these guys with your eyes. I can't explain it to you, but on the viewfinder I can see them. What is that? What is that, guys? I'm sure you can see it. It's probably just a stump. But I gotta go anyway. See, I'll be able to tell when I'm home watching that it wasn't anything, but on my monitor, it seemed black. I just want to check. I don't see it. shot that I just filmed, you guys. I keep hearing there's noises right next to me. What did I just zoom in on? Maybe it was that. I don't think it was. Or it would sound like a wood knock, but I don't think it was. Unless it was a little baby. Alright, I'm gonna go back to the spot. Now I can't even get back there. Man, I hope that was something cool. I can't tell. Where was I? See, now nothing's black there. I'll have to check it out when we get home. Let's hope it was something cool. See, the way the light hits the monitor, it can be hard to see stuff. They're just right around me right now. You guys, I have goosebumps. It doesn't matter how tough you are. When this stuff's happening, you get those feelings. This is actually not a bad spot. Okay, what I'm going to do, I'm going to turn the camera off. They know that I'm standing right here, so I'm going to go try to trick them. I did it last time, it worked. This giant being walked right by me, and the camera was off. I was face down. He was chasing Dan. He was actually moving really fast. And what happens, I get home and I have timestamps on it. People saw him. I tried to see, you can only see like a black thing behind the trees, you know, and I know it was him, but that's not what I'm looking for, you guys. I'm done with the blob squatches. I'm looking for the real deal. I'm trying to make it easy on you. Now, all that work that these guys have done is so important though, because it tells me where they are, how they're hiding, what they're doing, like how close I've been, because I know they're there, and I even recognize, I filmed this little 4-foot guy. I have a perfect picture of his face on Facebook. I filmed him at least 2 or 3 times now, and I recognize him every single time. He's my little buddy. I wish he would just come over. He's very curious. He's always out having fun trying to look at me. And I feel like it's fun because they're not monitoring me from a distance sometimes. They're literally right there, and I can move another 500 yards, and they're still right there. I think they're having fun. I mean, what else do you do out here all day long? If I were a human, why not mess with them? I would. Okay, so that whistle was down there. Probably one of those watchers. They have all these little perches, you guys, all the way down. One there, there's one there, there's one there. You can have for a mile or two. That's where we found one of those bones, right on one of the perches. Go figure. A little Bigfoot perch that overlooks the road that you can't see in from the road and see, but yet have a perfect view from the woods to the road. Here's a bone. People are like, why don't you send it in for DNA testing? Why would I send it in? For what? I know they're right here. I see them all the time, you guys. They're right here. I hear them all the time. And they're going to send me back results saying unknown primate. What's the point? I have hair samples, I have fingerprints on cups, I have endless pictures, videos. I mean, what more do you guys want? This is the best I can do until I get one out in the open. I feel like every time I come up, they change where they go sometimes. So this is where I heard my whistle. Just before. Nothing now. Bear with my camera adjustments. It's not moving. I think that's where they are. I'm going back that way. Let me get into that wallow. This thing, I call it the wallow. I'm tired of calling things a wallow. That's not what it means, but the term kind of fits. It kind of means this type of thing, you know, where you're. It kind of means a hangout to me, a place where they spend a lot of time. It'd be a wallow. It's protected. It's hard to get to. They have great view out and terrible view in, and they're everywhere. See, most people won't realize this, won't see this stuff, but, you know, even these randoms mean so much. This little random bend right there goes under another branch. It means something. They're all over the place here. You know, it's funny, in that case, it almost could have been by accident because there was a branch there, but it looks like they just picked up the branch and then just simply bent it over and put that down and put the branch on top of it. My guess is that branch is too light to have done that from, if it fell from, or I don't even think there is a place that could have fell from. It's too big for, anyway. Yeah, they just picked up that branch, bent that one over, and put one on top of it. Why, I have no idea. I can't figure it out. Just don't know. Alright, I'll click on when I'm back up there. Alright, I actually found an interesting new place. It's like a whole little, it's a place I've never been. I usually walk, the totem pole's up way over there. I usually walk in and I go that way. And I don't come down here because I know it's so down, it's like really straight downhill. And it's just, that's why I don't come down. I don't feel like walking back up it. But I saw all this. Now this is, okay, so this is their whole world, okay? Just go, bear with me. That's their whole entire world up there. It starts right there. You can, if you look carefully, you'll see all the structures, right? Got to here, which is very close. I'm talking like a 3-minute walk. And you got all this stuff. A completely barricaded off area. Could that have happened naturally? Absolutely. Did it? No. They do this to stop things from coming up the hill. This is protecting their area. Why? I don't know. I mean, I don't know what. I can't figure it out, you guys. I think there's a number of reasons. I don't think there's too many reasons for these, though. I believe when they make these fences, I don't know. I think it's almost a game thing, or even if it was a human, you know, they want you, instead of walking straight through there, they want you to have to go that way and cut up. I don't know why. It could have to do with the areas they stay in. Cool, I've never seen this before. It's not as exciting, but it's clearly their work. I have to assume they're still behind me. So, unfortunately for me, it looks like that's another place I'll have to check out someday. I believe there's probably not a whole lot down there, but this hill is really steep, you guys. I don't feel like going down there today. I don't see any real crazy paths going down there. And based on what the paths that are behind me, I mean, literally, you guys, Bigfoot paths. It's insane. Everywhere through there. Like, they're all protected on left and right. You can, nothing can see into these paths. It's amazing how they move. Little squirrel. So, not that there's nothing down there, but I'm not seeing enough signs to make me want to kill myself today. But definitely another area to check out one day. As you guys can see, I mean, I could just go on forever up here. I need to get out of here now, though. Today was mostly just a trail cam retrieval day. I think I'm going to leave my audio recorder out. I figured out how to get a 24-hour recording on it. So I'm going to leave it out. Probably right now somewhere. Even if it's out here for a week, I think it'll be okay. I'm going to put it somewhere it won't get wet. Although they're not waterproof, they kind of are like, you know, resistant slightly. So hopefully it'll be okay. I'm willing to risk it. I need an overnight recording. I have some, you guys, I have, for people that have not heard yet, I have the best audio. I just have not chopped it up yet because I don't know how. I've never had auto. So here's one of their trails. It's right to there. It goes right through here. Their trails always have, here's the difference between game trails, guys. Their trails always have these sticks. Little alarm sticks all over them. Look anywhere else, there's barely any of them. They're always on these brown trails. So, I have a audio of them actually walking by for about 6 minutes. Different ones going by. Someone even told me, sorry I forgot your name, but I didn't forget your message, that if you amplify it or slow it down, one of them says, where did the humans go? Or something like that. Maybe he'll message me again, because I'd like to get a hold of that. I haven't spent enough, a lot of time with the audio. Because I work full time. Barely get time to do anything. It was really broken. They're right here, and I can't find them. All right, I'm gonna do one more pan from where I got the Bigfoot sitting down video. Picture that's on, you guys always see on my Facebook and stuff. So I'm gonna do that down there, looking up that way, and see what happens, and then I'm out of here. So I'll click on in a minute. Leave in there. Right on the next. Sorry, I gotta straighten this camera. There we go. I know how loud that is when you're watching it. This is where they live, you can see. In there, how just those pine trees start, it just gets completely closed off. You cannot see a thing from in there. Apparently they come out here at night, they love doing this stuff. This is the open area, okay, where they do these structures that you can clearly see, I believe, from aircraft. I mean, I know it's crazy, but they're trying to signal someone up from above. That's for sure. Because why bother? Why do this out here? Why the totem poles over there, all that bent, gigantic, huge bends in the air and stuff. I have 20 suspended X's in the sky. You can't see until I go to the other side. That stuff is all brand new right there. I can't tell you what it is, but it's just happened in the last, I don't know, maybe a week or two. I've walked through here all the time. It's never been there. The only reason I know is because I saw it coming up. There's also a bunch of other new stuff. You know what? I'll just roll video. I'm running out of memory on this card, though. And I'll probably just stop with this card today. I'd left my other memory cards at home. Unfortunately, I knew I forgot something. Look at that. Bear. See that bear? It's definitely digging in there, guys. He dug that whole thing out. So to answer someone's question, I said this bear that was caught in the trail cams here, we have a good video of him and pictures of him, is a vegetarian. I'm almost sure. I mean, bears will eat anything, but I'm pretty sure he's 99% vegetarian, and that's the answer. He'll eat stuff. There's beehives like that all over the forest. You can walk over one and not even see it. And they'll eat a lot of that stuff. They turn over rocks, turn over logs, eat bugs, stuff like that. Termites. Mosquito on the back of my neck. It's a lot further than it looks. Just heard another whistle. That was really far away. That one you heard. It was like a popping noise. Alright, I got 7 minutes left. What I'm gonna do is I walk over this ridge. As soon as I drop down, I just dive to the ground and disappear, and I'll wait. I'll set up the camera somehow, and I'll just do my last 5 minutes like that. It worked last time, but I had Dan to distract. He kept going down, and he was whistling far down. They came right, or at least one of them came right by me. I mean, he was 100 feet over this way, and I was laying there. And I mean, he was moving fast, a fast walk, and it was loud. It was the first time I've ever heard one making walking noise. It was the first time I've seen them moving. They're typically too far to get any noise from the ground, stuff like that. Yes, I'm almost sure. People ask, what are the structures for? Well, besides a little hunting blind to hide behind, I believe that also breaks up ground noise. So if in other words, if one was walking 20 feet back there on the other side, the noise hits that and stops immediately, or at least breaks it down. Now, if he was to talk to me over that, it'd be fine. But the walking noise, I've noticed with Dan, it happens all the time. Like, I'm literally watching Dan really close to me, and there's not a noise coming from him. So I believe that's what a lot of these sticks on the ground do. It limits the noise. So even though you can hear me as loud as day, because it's right here, that way it's not as loud. And I think I can use that to their advantage as well. If they use it against me, I'll use it against them. They love to do that. Those little, I call them slingshots, but little V-shaped trees. I'm a little bit further left than I wanted to be. All right, I'm turning the camera off, and I'll turn it back on when I get set up. Okay, so I just left everything and I walked up there, set audio in a really good spot. As I was setting audio, I got whistles, so the whistle should be on the audio. It was pretty loud, actually. At least one really good one. It's a little hunting, a little... I was standing in there, I'll tell you, if you go in there, you're completely covered. You have all these great views going down. There's like a lot of long views from here. You got a lot, plenty of time to see something coming and get out. Now, there's still, as of 1 minute ago, whistling below me, so I figured I would just film my way out, which I usually don't do because I feel like it's not going to be that much action, but they're clearly below me. I said below. I know what you're thinking. Oh, I think I saw another one. Oh, there's a little bird. There he is, right there. Every time I'm here, guys. Every time. What's up, buddy? Where is he? There he is. He's so close to me right now. He's either Bigfoot's pet, or he likes those sunflower seeds, so I'll give him. I don't eat sunflower seeds, so they always get all of them. I find it really interesting. He just landed right on my head. Such a friendly bird, but no matter where I am. See, you would think, like, oh, if you're near their nest, or which isn't happening this time of year anyway, or just an area they don't want you in, but this thing finds me no matter where I am. Every time I come, he'll come and he'll hang out. He's somewhere really close still right now. I can't tell. He's on the other side of that tree. He'll come hang out with me, and then he leaves. Probably nothing, but what a coincidence that is. Every time that guy, he could land 20 feet above me, but he lands right on top of my head practically. So I'm convinced that's a little perch right there. It's just a clear place to watch. Hold on, I gotta fix this. To watch things coming up the hill. Right in there. I'll tell you, if you were walking by, you'd barely notice it. Sit still, just keep still on your zone. Just remember, guys, the farther you zoom on any camera, the harder it is to hold it still. And then leading up to that blind, you have a whole nother stack of trees here going here for which way. With an X right next to it. They so know where I am right now. I don't know why I'm whispering anymore. Just in case they whistle again. Okay, look at the road. You almost see it from here. There you go. This road is brutal, you guys. It's not this, when I say road, I don't mean like a road people drive down. It is the bumpiest truck beating on road you'll ever be on. It's just, especially now, it is so bad. They just fixed it. I spent like a month doing that road. That road's like 25 miles long. And it's completely like undrivable, which I like because it keeps less people from coming up here. Even up in the road, I mean. I don't think any, even the hunters, you can see there's a lot of hunters out today and there's no one in this area. Because who wants to walk up this hill? Like, you're not gonna walk up there, go shoot a moose and then have to drag, you know, 500 pounds down the hill. This is not gonna happen. I guess downhill would be better than nothing, so. me, that's a seat. You know, and then it's always next to something like this. It's never just random, you guys. There's always some kind of wacko. Even though it's just a tree lean, it's still put there by them. And then they'll sit there, but they can't sit there without this tree, without some weird tree there, or without an X, or without, they won't just go over there and sit by that tree. It has to be a tree that has this. That's why the autism thing, I really buy into the autism. Is it like an autism kid that we know? No, I believe it's slightly different, affects them differently, but there is an autism type of thing going on there. Like I said, they won't just sit there. It's gotta have this. Okay, it's amazing. This is the third time this year, this trip, I found that yellow jackets, or a bee, or a bear has completely destroyed the hive. You can see the hive right here. It's right in there. My finger can't. It's a little too zoomed, and they're repairing. So that's how that bear eats up here. Someone's like, how do they live without meat? Well, if you get 100 of those a day, you're doing just fine. Probably not even 100. They're just everywhere. All right, guys. And they're being so careful today. They're keeping a distance all of a sudden, okay? Two times ago, they came right up next to me. I thought it was like groundbreaking. I thought I was so excited. Like, this is amazing. Every time I come here, they're going to be right next to me now. They're starting to trust me. And then all of a sudden, the last two times, coincidentally, bow season has started during those two times. I don't know. There is no bow hunters here, or haven't been. There's no really way to get in here, I mean, or to park. So I'm assuming that doesn't affect them that much, but it could. You know, maybe they're just aware of it, and who knows what they've dealt with in the past. And if they're autistic, as I think they are, they probably remember that very well and know what time of year that happens, and they're just being cautious. I don't know. They're clearly doing their circle around me. Like, usually they're right around me, and today they've been like way, like almost like as far as my finger's pointing away, and they're going like this. And they're going up. Hey guys. Alright, this is really steep here. So I'm just out of breath. As you can see down there is the road. This is a new spot that I don't talk about. That I've been wanting to check out. And already, it's really cool. I'm already filmed at the other place all day. It's late, but I wanted to come up here a little bit. Look at this thing. I've never seen a uglier looking structure, but I believe it is a structure. Look at that, the size of that thing, and it's leaning uphill. I'm following a little, what appears to be a game trail. Just a strange looking structure here. Oh, you guys, this is gonna be good in here. You gotta see some of the stuff I can see. It's crazy. There's another kind of sort of a path through here. You can kind of tell. Now, this is not people, because there's paint up here, but it's for the trees. See beyond that, it's just amazing. These are all, there's so many signals from the road. Right, there's a bend there. There's also a parallel. Look how parallel that one tree is. Where is it? Look at that. I don't think that makes a cool structure over there, but right now I'm going up the hill. I already see other ones too. This is cool. I'm whispering because I've never been here before. I'll bet you, at the top of that hill, is payday. Well, camera payday. Not that I ever make any money. Here, let's see. Okay, what are the chances, you guys? Check this out. new spot, new totem pole. It's like a face on it. Sounds like a bird. Are you guys, this is a hot spot. I'm not kidding you. Hold on, I gotta fix this. Holy crap. I left everything in the car. My tripod's falling apart. Hold on. Oh, there's another one right there. That's insane. Or it's gonna be. Wait till I find the main area for here. Sorry, I'm trying to stick my tripod back in. There we go. Oh my god. Okay, you know what? I'm gonna go without a tripod. Just take this stupid thing off. It's killing me. Good, I'll click right back on. Alright. Sorry about that, you guys. Alright, this place is too cool. In case I don't put the other clip in, I think I will when I first walked in. Just having tripod problems. This is a new spot I've never been to. I've been looking at it from the road, which is way down there. But you can look up. I actually looked through my sunroof, and I can see everything. I'm telling you, this it's too steep here for them to be habitating, but these are all signs of something. And I'm willing to bet that they're up there. But I just don't have the time today, you guys. I don't have anything on me. I do have protection, but I don't have any water or anything lighter or nothing. I heard noises when I first came in. But on the ground type of noises, I don't know what it was. It's very quiet here. I would love to find a spot without aliens. This is an amazing X, you guys, right here. Okay, first of all, it's leaning downhill. This is a really steep hill. Give me an idea of how steep it is, especially there. I mean, it's steep. You could climb up, but you're gonna be hurting. Okay, and then look. Check this out. This is awesome. I'm glad I stopped. Another one. Wow, I didn't even see that one. Look at that. Okay, again, as always, fences. I see something white, but I don't know what it is. My tripod is like breaking on me, guys. I'm sorry. Wow. Guys, I have a new spot. This is too cool. I know I had this place, but I hadn't walked in here and actually like seen it in person yet. This is just too wild. Now down there, here's like one of the things I saw from the road. Look, check this out. Like perfect X's. Just facing the road. There's no sun on the side either now. It's already getting dark in here. Oh, I love it. I love it. This is amazing. See all the fences up there? See, new area, they tend to be more curious. And they'll come in and check you out. Once they know you know, I think they back up a little bit. But every time I've come into a new place, I've had really good luck. Like, really good luck. Nothing so far, but I want to go up so bad. You guys, it's steep. All right, well, new spot. Another new spot. Why? Oh, they must be watching me. I'm gonna do a whistle. Sorry guys, I am shaking a little bit from walking up the hill. Know what part of this I'm at, you know what I mean? Like, this is gonna be another really big place. I mean, it's big here. I can see where something is just ripped right up this hill. Here's another little, looks like a game trail. Yeah. See guys, that's game, I think, because it's thin. You walk with four legs. I'm sure Bigfoot jumps on it occasionally, but it looks like it was made by animals. And they will tend to parallel roads. I gotta get up to this hunting blind area, wallow, whatever you wanna call it. I always see that stuff in their area. Oh yeah, they're here. They gotta be here. Look at this. Sorry about the breathing. But that is steep. They did all this. Look at this thing. There's no stump. It goes all the way down there. There's another wreck right somewhere. Right there. There's another wreck. Right there. Whew. Excuse me. Alright. I'm just gonna try to get to here. And I have no choice but to call it a day. But I will be back. See, here's another thing. I don't know if it's in this video or not, but I was at this other area. I said it was very witch-like. There was no structures, but there was just all kinds of weird trees like that. And I know it's normal, but it's also not. Because they tend to be right in the middle of this. And then there's always, you know, these blatant tree lanes. You guys, this place is recent. This is this summer for sure. I mean, look, to approach this is almost impossible. It is so steep. me catch my breath and I'll turn it back on. All right, I'm having trouble recovering from that one. I don't know if you can tell, but it's, for some reason when I see in the video, I'm like, no, it's much steeper. It's really steep, you guys. It's like, well, whatever. So, okay, how cool is this? I have a new place. I found a Bigfoot trail. And it just leads straight up. I mean, this stuff that's back there could be, oh my God, it could be the best spot ever, you guys. I'm not kidding. Okay, just based on the stuff I'm seeing on a slope like this, where nothing, I don't care if you're a Bigfoot or not, you don't really want to hang out here. It's, I mean, I'm standing like this just to be, not to fall down. So this tells me that when it levels off up there, it's got to be good. I might keep going a little bit. I don't even care at this point. By the time I get home. Because how cool is this? I mean, this is on a huge hill. There's a lot of activity here, which tells me this is another big area. It's not just one or two Bigfoot. This is a place that's got a lot of things going on. They're here. Wow, this is too cool. Too cool. I'm so excited. Look at that tree up in the air. It's not quite as pretty yet as the other place, but a lot going on. Now that just happened to be in the air, right? And it made an X. I'm willing to bet a perfect X. So you know that they're above me. I'm standing right next to one. Look how long that is. It makes one there. Stuck on a pine tree up there. Well, if they're here, they're definitely watching me from up there because. Let's see if I can balance on this stick. Stops uphill. I can't imagine the footprints that must be here in the snow. Here's the thing, no one's ever seen it. You can't get here. Wow, look at that X, you guys. It keeps getting better and better. Judgment when I keep going. I'm really thirsty. These little military walkways here. Military crests. Again, this one is looking a little game traily. It's thin. It doesn't look like what I call a Bigfoot trail. Like in my Bigfoot universe, they have these beautiful, soft, dirt, wide trails. The game, you know, they stay in a single line. Especially because when they're on these mountains and they just become these thin little trails. So I call that game trail. Not a Bigfoot trail. Hey guys, this is hard. I mean, you wonder why we have GoFundMes and stuff. It's not to beg for anything. You guys come up here and try doing this. I've already been out for 7 hours in the woods somewhere else. This is brutal. Ooh, look at that. What, that's a footprint. I think that's a footprint. A baby footprint. A little one. Yeah. You don't see him too much here. The toes and the heels over here. It's about as good as it gets here, you guys, really. It's as good as it gets. A little one. Like that's a little one. right up here. It's real soft here. Look, there's another one here. Another one, another one, another one. Look at this place. No wonder they're here, because no person would ever want to walk up this. Why would you walk up this? Another one, a little traverse trail. Okay, so you guys, it just keeps going and going and going up there. I will come back. I hopefully do it this year. Maybe next time I'll get my auto recorder that I left out the other place and just come here. I have a feeling if I go up there, it's gonna be special. Just like me, special. Right. And I meant that in the dumb way. Look at this crazy stuff. Man, I get some vibes in here. I don't know if it's because I'm just excited or what, but I'm getting like, someone's been here, look. It's really, really old. That could be 20, 30 years old. If something's on a tree like that, it doesn't get weathered much. Wonder why they would mark up here. I'm so far away from like anything. This is weird that they have marked up here. Why would you couldn't cut, you couldn't even drag them out. Okay, so new spot.